plant breeding in one of the technique back cross. What is back cross? How the back cross is useful? In case of the back cross, it can be defined F1 is crossed with the either of the parents is known as the back cross. In case of the back cross, we can transfer a single gene from the donor plant to recipient parent. In this case, one of the crop plant which is very good in all the characters up to 99% of the genome, but one or two characters which are lacking in that plant, that is excel in other character. For that, we need to transport a gene from where the disease resistance character is there in other variety we can transport. So in this case, whatever the plant which is agronomically very good, that can be used as a recurrent parent. The other parent which is having one or two characters which are having, for example, disease resistance, which may be driven from the donor plant to recipient parent, that is known as the non-recurrent parent. So one of the two examples in the rice variety, Pusa Basmati and Sona Masoori, these two rice crops are very good in nature and they are lacking one of the disease resistant character like XA21, which is caused one of the gene having the disease resistant or the bacterial blight. In rice, bacterial blight which is caused by the Xanthomonas variety. So this, wherever this character XA21 gene is there, we can transport a gene from the donor plant to recipient parent. So we can take the recurrent parent is agronomically sound. The non-recurrent parent which is having one or two characters which is good. So for that we can get the, by crossing these Sona Masoori or Pusa Basmati with closely related rice variety which is having the gene of XA21. Whatever the F1 is obtained which is having the XA21 disease resistant character. So we need not test at F1 level. Then the whatever the F1 is obtained is crossed with the recurrent parent, that is the Sona Masoori or Pusa Basmati. And we can repeat this BC1. In the BC1, the 75% of the rice genome from the Sona Masoori and only 25% from the whatever the donor plant genome is there. And we need to test whether the XA21 gene is there or not by using the exposing the disease. And we need to see the any phenotypic markers are there. So whatever the BC1 plant again is crossed with the recurrent parent, for example Sona Masoori, and in this case whatever only the 12.5% of the genome is coming from the non-recurrent parent, whereas the remaining percentage of the genome may be from the recurrent parent. So like this, in the BC3 generation, whatever the 6.25 is converted in the form of the 3.12, like that. So like this we can get the 99% of the genome from the Sona Masoori and only 1% of the genome from which is coming from the donor plant which is having the XA21, that is having the bacterial blight disease resistant. So like this, in the traditional method of the rice crop improvement or any crop plant improvement by using the back cross method, in this case we can drive the single gene from the donor plant to the recipient parent by taking one of the parent as a recurrent parent, the parent which is having 99% of the good characters, agronomically very sound, and we can transport a single gene, for example XA21, from the donor plant. So like this we can do the back cross 6 or 7 generation. The total background, that is just like a Sona Masuri, and only the foreground in the form of the XA21, that is the 99 plus 1 factor in the form of the XA21, because of that it is having the bacterial blight disease resistance. By using the molecular markers instead of doing the 6th generation, we can take the F1 maybe self-food, or BC1 maybe self-food, and we can see the certain phenotype markers, and we can isolate the DNA by knowing the genes left and right borders of the XA21. By using the any rapids, we can analyze the genome, and most of the whatever the phenotypic characters of the mother plant of the recurrent parent, and only the gene of interest which is there on the molecular basis also, we can check it, and we can do the 1 or 2 generations, we can get the just like the back cross method. So this is one of the crop improvement in case of the back cross. Back cross is one which is a single gene driven from the donor plant to the recipient parent. Thank you. Role of triploids in the crop improvement. Triploids generally consisting of 3 sets of the chromosomes. In this case, we can improve the crop in case of the sugar beet, Beta vulgaris. In this case, either of the diploids or tetraploids, whatever the roots which are containing the less size than the triploids. The triploids generally we will produce by crossing the tetraploids with the diploids, we will produce the triploids. In this case, the tetraploid plant we will take in as a female, and the diploid plant we will take as a male plant, and we can produce the triploids. The triploids at polyploidy level is more heterozygous than the diploids. At the same time, they are having the good quality in production of the sugar, and the size of the root is more than the normal diploid plant. So the sugar beets which are containing n equal to 11 chromosomes, and the triploids which are containing the 33 chromosomes. So sugar beet, we can also see the triploids in case of the watermelons. So in case of the watermelons, we can produce the triploids by crossing the tetraploids with the diploids. And the advantage in case of the fruit crops, the size of the fruit is more than the either of the diploids or the tetraploids. And when the triploids won't produce the proper seed, because of that we will get the a fruit which is ready to eat, and the seeds won't obstruct while we are eating. So watermelon is one of the best example for the triploids, where we have the n equal to chromosome 11, and triploids which are having the 33 chromosomes. So in this we need to produce the triploids by crossing the tetraploids with the diploids, and we will produce the triploids. So, and also we need the proper pollination for the production of the fruits in the form of the 5 triploids with 1 diploid. We need to do certain artificial pollination to produce the proper fruits in case of the watermelons. And also we can see the triploids banana, one of the vegetatively propagated crop, which is n equal to 11 chromosomes, and the triploids, that is in the form of the 33 chromosomes, and we can get a seedless banana. But anyhow, the banana seed is very small in size, but we never think that banana having a seed, and it is vegetatively propagated crop, and we can see that is also one of the best example for the triploids in addition to watermelons and the sugar beets. Best example for the triploids, that is the tea crop which is there in the Assam, Camellia assamica, and TV 29, which is produce the more biomass than the normal diploids, and we can multiply this crop plant by method of the vegetative. So Camellia assamica, which is having the good tea content in the leaves and the biomass, and also it is very good. That is also one of the best example for the triploids. In addition to diploids, triploids, and we can also see the allopolyploids in the crop improvement. Wheat is the one of the best example for the allopolyploid, and it is an hexaploid consisting of three genomes: A genome, B genome, and the T genome. The basic chromosome of the wheat n equal to 7. So in the allopolyploid, which is developed in the Afghanistan field naturally, it consisting of three genomes: A genome, B genome, and D genome. A triticum monococcum is crossed with the triticum CRC, and also known as the grass species Agilopsa speltoides. So whatever the outcoming genome or the tetraploid plant consisting of AA genome and the BB genome. The F1, which is containing the AB genome, which is maybe treated with the colchicine, will be converted into tetraploid, but it is naturally converted into tetraploid. This is the triticum dicocum, and it is a tetraploid and also known as the triticum turgidum. And the triticum turgidum or tetraploid plant is crossed with the D genome, and that is Agilopsa squareja, and also triticum tavuchi, and it is consisting of D genome in addition to AA, BB, DD genome, and the chromosome number n equal to 6 into 7, 42 chromosomes, and 21 pairs of the chromosome. So in this B genome, triticum CRC, which is contributed in the form of the fifth B chromosome, which is controls the homologous pairing rather than the homeologous pairing. So what is homologous pairing? Pairing of the BB or AA genome on its own chromosomes, known as the homologous pairing. Pairing of AA with AA only, and BB genome only, BB only. So that is known as the homologous. In case of the pairing of A with B or B with D, that is known as the homeologous chromosome. So fifth B chromosome, which contributes the homologous pairing, that is the contributed by the triticum CRC or Agilopsa speltoides, that is a closely related grass species. In case of the D genome, which is having the drought tolerance, and it contributes the drought resistance, and it is the triticum tauchi. So like this, with we have the Russian names: triticum CRC, triticum turgidum, triticum tauchi. So like this, this is the one of the modern bread wheat hexaploid, and it is having the six pairs of the chromosome, which is improved in the crop improvement. Generally polyploids, it won't form the seed, but we know the some of the crop plants which are polyploids, like sugar cane and potato, they are the polyploids. And the seed is not the important portion in case of the crop improvement. Like this, we can see one of the best example, allopolyploid wheat, and it is improved the crop production, and most of the world is dependent on the wheat. In addition to hexaploid wheat, another crop plant in the form of the tetraploid, that is the cotton crop, Gossypium species. In the Gossypium species, which in the form of the diploids, and we can also see the tetraploids. And in this case, we can see that there are two kinds of the species in the form of the old world cotton and the new world cotton. We can distinguish the old world cotton with the new world cotton. The chromosome size is in the old world cotton is longer than the new world cotton. So most of the Asian species which will be considered as a old world cotton, the form of the Gossypium herbaceum or arboreum, which is there from the India, and in case of the American species, in the form of the Gossypium tuberi and other species. So cotton is also one of the accidentally developed the tetraploid. It is a cross in between old world and the new world. Maybe the old world consisting of A genome and the new world that is consisting of the D genome. So it is a cross in between Gossypium herbaceum or arboreum is crossed with the Gossypium tuberi, and the outcoming cotton crop in the form of the Gossypium hirsutum, it is consisting of A genome and the genome D genome. So the whatever the tetraploid which is containing AA and the DD genome, the basic chromosome N equal to 13 chromosome, and the tetraploid the chromosome number is 13 into 4 is 52 chromosomes. We know that the cotton crop, we can use both the seed as well as the cotton fiber, which is coming from the seed coat hairs from the trichomes. So this is one of the best examples where the trichomes, which will be useful economically. Generally, the trichomes do not have the any importance. A single-celled trichome, we will see, which is consisting of the cellulose, and it is one of the important after the food crops, we in the form of the cloth we obtained from the cotton. So Gossypium hirsutum, which is one of the American upland cotton which is cultivated 85% of the world. So we know that either of the old world cotton and the new world cotton, Gossypium arboreum or tuberi, the cotton fiber length is smaller than the whatever the tetraploid plant Gossypium hirsutum. So it might be the cuticles which contributes the longer fiber than the either of these parents. That indicates this is one of the best example for the cuticles quantitative trait loci. In case of the crop improvement, we can see in the cotton where the Gossypium hirsutum, which is a tetraploid plant, and we can produce the more cotton worldwide. It is important, a tetraploid plant and consisting of AA and DD genome, and the chromosome number that is in the form of 52. Anyhow, the cotton nowadays is modified. Even the transgenic method, we introduce the BT genes, and the BT genes which are useful in case of the insect resistance, like the one of the bollworm, like this. Triticale is one of the allopolyploid. It is a cross in between Triticum dichocum or Triticum turgidum, that is a tetraploid consisting of AA and BB genome, which is containing the high yielding character, and it is crossed with a sequel serial or genome N equal to 7, and it is form of the outcoming plant triticale. It is a man-made allopolyploid. It is having the two characters in the form of the hardiness of the sequel serial and the high yielding nature of the wheat, that is the a tetraploid plant crossed with the diploid, that is in the form of the Triticum dichocum or Triticum turgidum with the sequel serial, and the outcoming, that is the triticale. It is a man-made, and it is a hexaploid, and the crop improved is done by using the triticale. Glossica genus, we can see the in the form of the diploids and the tetraploids. Basically, there are three diploids are there in the form of the Brassica nigra, which is containing the B genome, Brassica campestris, which is containing the A genome, and Brassica walrasia, which is containing the C genome. The Brassica campestris n equal to 10 A genome, and Brassica nigra n equal to 8 and consisting of the B genome, and Brassica walrasia C genome 9 chromosomes. So like this we can see the in the form of the Brassica campestris and Brassica nigra and the Brassica walrasia. The Brassica gentia, it is a tetraploid plant which is a cross in between the Brassica nigra and Brassica campestris in the form of the Brassica gentia, that is the Indian mustard, and it is containing the 10 plus in the form of the 18 plus 18, that is in the form of the 36 chromosomes. In between Brassica campestris and Brassica walrasia, consisting of A genome and the C genome, that is in the form of the Brassica napus, that is in the form of the rape seed. It is in the form of the 10 plus 9, 19 plus 19 in the form of the 38 chromosome. In addition to another tetraploid, we can see in between the Brassica nigra and the Brassica walrasia, B genome and C genome, and that is in the form of the Brassica carinata, and in the form of the BC genome, and 9 plus 8, 17 chromosomes, 17 plus 17, that is in the form of the 34 chromosomes. It is a triangle crop evolution. We can see a cross in between Brassica campestris and Brassica nigra and the Brassica walrasia. The Indian mustard, which is a cross in between Brassica nigra and the Brassica campestris in the form of the Brassica gentia. And a cross in between Brassica campestris and the Brassica walrasia, that is in the form of the Brassica napus. And a cross in between Brassica nigra and Brassica walrasia, that is in the form of the carinata. Like this, we can see the some of the polyploids which are there in the crop improvements, either in the form of the triploids or the tetraploids. In addition to this, we can also see the polyploids in the flower industry. In case of the polyploids, in the case of the cut roses, they are the polyploids, and they are containing the thick petals and the dark in color, and they are very much useful, and their blooming period is improved, but the fragrance is very less. So like this, the best example in case of the flower industry, the polyploids, or in case of the cut flowers which are having the thick petals and dark in color, they are very much useful in case of the flower industry. So like this, we have the in the form of the polyploids, maybe in the form of the tetraploids and the hexaploids, and also in the form of the triploids and other polyploids which are improved in the crop improvement. And we generally we will see the ploidy is more in case of the tuber crops like potato, and also where the seed is not important in case of the sugar cane, and also in case of the ginger, maybe they are the mostly polyploids. Thank you.